Giving hearts are lifting spirits and raising money, all for the art of healing. Hello and welcome to Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Yolanda Vasquez and I'm coming to you from the 9th annual Tracy's Kids Red Carpet event in Washington, D.C.
It's a sellout. I mean, you can hardly fit in the room here.
The gala is the best event that exists in Washington.
And it's not a big, long dinner, lots of speeches. They have a fun program.
Where else can you come and watch six award-winning, nominated films right in the heart of Hollywood's award season? This is all about having fun on behalf of a great, great program that helps children who are very sick.
Some people think about art therapy as just doing arts and crafts, but it's really more than that. We have to treat the whole child. And part of treating the whole child is letting them express themselves.
But what we found was that the art really helped the kids and families relax and feel a lot more grounded and normal and able to cope when they were there at the clinic.
I had cancer as a kid. I was diagnosed as a 10-year-old, and I get the emotional toll that the disease imposes on children.
The organization grew out of my work at the Lombardi Cancer Center, which started there in 1991. We now have programs at Children's National Medical Center and a program in Northern Virginia and one in San Antonio, Texas.
All these art therapists have their master's degree. They actually are trained in a mental health background, yeah. And so they're able to actually interpret the art, and it's fascinating to see them talk about the artwork.
Everybody wants matrix, they want numbers, they want to know how will this affect survival rates. And the bottom line is, it'll put a smile on a young cancer victim's face. And no one can measure that. That is an intangible that you can't put a price tag on.
It's not that art therapy is going to make you get rid of your cancer. What art therapy is going to do is make it tolerable to come to the hospital and get the treatments that you need.
It's more than art. It's, you know, time to get away from your doctors, get away from the needles, get away from the blood, get away from, you know, everything else that's going on upstairs.
We know for certain, those of us who are survivors, that matters. And to those families, it matters. To the people who you serve every day, it matters.
This is a disease that doesn't just affect the victim. This is a disease that challenges the entire family. I obviously see this from the perspective of my children, who were quite young when I was diagnosed. And I know how terrifying that was for them.
About 5 years ago, my son, then 3 and a half, was diagnosed with a brain tumor. He immediately started chemotherapy, and it would include 5-7 hour stints at the clinic. Tracy's Kids program was not only a way to keep busy, there's that, but a way to channel your feelings through the art. Not just for Clay, but especially for his sister, the sibling of a patient. They're healthy. They don't get any of the attention, but they get all the fear. They feel all of the grief, all the worry.
There's some little piece of us that wants to tuck feelings away sometimes, and for children, sometimes they just don't know how to say what they're feeling, but they can draw it. It's a great tool.
This is as good, as powerful, and as impactful a program as I've ever seen.
I'm honored to be here, honored to do anything I can for young children.
People are very excited about the cause. It's a great cause, and it's great to see people rally for Tracy's Kids.
This is a program that really gets it, really gets what's happening with young cancer patients and helps families survive this terrible disease.
And the winner truly is Tracy's Kids. I'm Yolanda Vasquez, and thank you for watching Comcast Newsmakers.